I can't project. We have a sonata by Johann Sebastian Bach. He was born in 1685. Actually, it's almost his birthday, March 21st. So wish everybody happy Bach's birthday in just a couple of days here. He is obviously the German composer. He came from several generations of musicians. And unfortunately, he was orphaned at the age of 10 and went to live with one of his big brothers, Johann Christoph, who was a church organist. And he stayed with him and his family until he was about 15. And during his childhood, he trained as a singer, as a violinist, as an organ and harpsichordist, and also in composition and theory. When he was 19, he married his second cousin, Maria Barbara. Her last name was Bach, before she married him. And they had seven kids together. And during his career, he was working at the court of Duke Leopold. And he went to tell the Duke at one point that he was offered a new position by someone else, got a slightly better offer. And the Duke promptly threw him in jail for several weeks. So that really makes you want to stay in the job, doesn't it? Eventually, his first wife did die, and he married yet another second cousin, and her last name was Bach, too, Anna Magdalena Bach. She was 17 years his junior. She was a singer, and they went on to have 13 children. So he was very prolific, not only in his compositions, but also in his offspring. And four of his sons did grow up to be well-known composers in their own right. When he was about 35, he wrote this set of nine sonatas for violin and harpsichord, and this has four movements, the dolce, which is sort of a slower movement, and the allegro, an andante movement, and finally it says presto, but it's a presto on the slower side, because we think it sounds better that way. And it's kind of nice to play these, because a lot of times people will play the modern violin and piano in these sonatas, and then it sort of sounds like a violin being accompanied by a piano. It feels much more collaborative on the early instruments, that we are equal partners in this, and you can hear a little bit more of the voicing better. So we hope you enjoy this sonata by Bach. On a new E string, and it's sort of a problem child.